Welcome to today's episode of Automotive Weekly. In today's video, we're going to check out Josh's daily.
This is my 2015 Mini Cooper 3-door. It has a 1.5-liter 3-cylinder turbocharged engine that makes 134 horsepower and 164 foot-pounds of torque. Despite not having a ton of power, it's a pretty quick car, thanks to the fact that it only weighs 2,600 pounds. It's a great daily driver for me because it gets great gas mileage and it has plenty of room for my daughter's massive car seat. And it's fun to drive.
Josh, do you know what I really, really like?
What's that?
Continuity. Hence the fact that we're wearing different shirts, it's cloudy outside, and the Mini looks a little different since the last time you saw it, which was just a few seconds ago, but for us it's been a little bit more than that. But that's okay, we'll talk about that more later. But first, Josh, I kind of wanted to sit down and kind of figure out what exactly it is about Minis that you like so much, and why did you buy one in the first place? So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, so I only have one car, so it's my daily driver. I needed something practical, which, okay, it's small, but it you know, it's just me and my daughter at this point.
Sure.
So I don't need anything huge on the inside.
The back seat's pretty spacious.
I mean, she's fine back there. She
yeah.
does great. And you saw footage of the car seat back there. She's fine.
And that's a giant freaking car seat. Let's
yeah,
just be real.
It is
here.
Big. I'm big on safety.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta be safe as I'm hitting the corners.
No, what's that? Canyon carving.
Canyon carving. Actually,
on a future episode of Automotive Weekly.
No, so back to super practical, great gas mileage. It's like 40 miles per gallon.
Is it really?
On highway. And so I love taking it on long trips. Those are the reasons why I could like pursue this car that I've liked for so long.
Yeah.
It wasn't like, you know, like a Corvette or something like that, you know,
right.
No gas mileage.
Or like my car.
Way more expensive. I didn't want to talk about your car like that.
Yeah,
but like
my car's small. But
it has your car, okay, but that's a perfect example. It has a back seat. And I actually did look at your car. It has a back seat. Yours doesn't.
No, mine doesn't.
But most cars like yours have a back seat. But it wasn't practical because that back seat is way smaller than this one.
Yeah.
Way smaller. And it was a little more expensive. So I needed a certain price range too.
Absolutely. If you don't mind me asking, what was the price range for that car when you were
looking at those? So I got this one used, had 27,000 miles on
it. Still under warranty, isn't it?
Yeah, still under warranty. Still, it's only sitting at 40,000 right now.
That's awesome.
So it's still under warranty. It was 13.5.
That's really not bad at all.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's not bad.
Yeah. I mean, it's all BMW made, really. So it's kind of like getting a BMW for cheap.
Yeah.
It drives like it anyways.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And after I've ridden in your car a couple times, and honestly, it's very surprising just how smooth it is. Like, even when we're in some of the bumpier roads around this area, it's just consistently smooth the entire time. And I was blown away by that.
For great. Such a small car, you'd think it would be really
harsh.
Bumpy and harsh.
Oh, definitely.
And, you know, something we did.
We'll talk again more about that
last
later.
Last week may have made that a little worse, but it's fine.
We definitely learned Germans like to keep their cars together.
They do.
But again, more on that later. So, I know one of the things that I wanted to talk to you about, you've previously mentioned to me, not to the fine people of the internet, that you really like the community surrounding these cars.
Yes, absolutely. I love vehicles with a following, vehicles with a community, where it's like I see somebody with a Mini Cooper and I just like, we're instant friends.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like, and I can't put my finger on why that is with certain cars and not other cars. For instance, like a Camry. Those cars, you don't see somebody else that owns a Camry and you're like, hey, Camry. No, you just don't.
It's true.
And it's funny to think about that, but why is it funny? I don't know. But the Mini Cooper, it's like you instantly have this family. You're like, hey, I like your car. They're like, hey, I like your car. It's like this, you know, fun joke that only we have.
I think it's one of the things that I love so much about the car community in general is, and even when you show up to shows and stuff like that, some people are like, they'll just come up to you, even if your car is bone stock, and say, man, I think that's really cool. And that's one of the things I love just about the car community as a whole. I mean, I think a lot of times we get a bad rap because you got, you know, Honda Civic guys running down, you know, with a $1,000 car with, you know, exhaust coming straight out of the hood.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think that gives us a bit of a bad rap, but honestly, that's one of the things I love so much is the car community realistically is, you know, it's like that brotherly bond.
Yeah,
it's
genuine people.
Very much so.
Yeah, they care about each other for the most part.
For the most part, yeah. So Josh, we've talked a lot about like the car and its form and why the reasons you bought it. So let's talk a little bit about mods. Mm-hmm. So what all has been done to it so far?
So the first thing I did was I tinted the windows. Mm. And I got them as dark as I'm comfortable with. That's the first thing I love doing with every car. It really just changes the total look of the car itself.
Yeah.
So that was the first thing.
Nice.
And then last week we...
Yes. Last week we actually put lowering springs on this. And you're kind of looking at a final product, but you can't really see it that well.
I would cover it up, but they've kind of been looking at it all the whole time.
In our next episode, we're going to be putting lowering springs on the Mini, and you'll see it's actually a little bit more difficult than you'd expect it to, but we ended up getting to work out pretty well. Last time.
5 hours, I think?
Yeah.
So, you'll see.
But the funny, see. Except for the fact that half of it took 3 hours, and the other half took like an hour and a half, let's be real.
Yeah, that's true.
But,
and then always the trip to...
AutoZone.
That's a pink Frontier?
That kind of is a pink Frontier.
Or not Frontier, but...
I was a little grumpy that day, but because I was working on the Subaru, which is it's the episode after that. But overall, yeah, it actually was a very fun experience. And
yeah.
I'm glad we got a chance to do that.
I think it went well. It didn't take forever. If we had to do it again, it would take a lot less time.
Oh my gosh, totally. Now that we know what we're doing, it makes it so much better. Anyone who's modified their car will definitely agree with the fact, once you do it the first time, it's so much easier after that.
For sure. So well, that's all I've done so far.
Yeah.
And
more on the way though, right?
Yeah, more on the way. The future is I like for it to look good and sound good. Mm. I mean, there's a couple things I want to do, like Dynatronics makes a little thing that plugs into your, I think it's an O2 sensor maybe, that like tricks it into having more boost.
Yeah.
But nothing crazy as far as speed. I'm not replacing the turbo on it. I mean, like we talked about earlier, it's still under warranty.
Sure.
So I'm not going crazy with that. But yeah, I just want it to look good and sound good and probably get some new rims when it needs new tires. But that's about it. I mean.
And I think it's a really reasonable plan. It's not like you're trying to go for like a track monster or anything crazy like that. I mean, I've seen some cool mini track cars, but for a daily driver, you really don't need like roll cages and all that nonsense.
Exactly. So,
but cool. Josh, thanks for sitting down and talking with us and about how you've got your Mini and, you know, what the reasons we are liking it and everything. Yeah. It's kind of cool to hear that. Like, some of that stuff I didn't even know about, so I was excited to hear about that. So, be sure to tune in next week, though, as we install the lowering springs on this. We'll have that out Friday sometime between 1 and 3 o'clock. And if you want to keep up to date with us, you can follow us on both Facebook and Instagram. The links will be on screen as well as in the description below. And we will be back next week with some more Mini Madness.
So that was something special that's not oatmeal driving on the road is what I wanted.
Even if your car's a little oatmeal colored, but that's a good color.
Come on,
it's
now.
No, I'm sorry, that won't go in,
it's
I promise.
Moonlight silver? White silver. Moonlight white silver, I think.
Right on.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.